Thank you for joining us for the April 15th, 2013 Kirksville City Council meeting.
I'll go ahead and call this meeting the Kirksville City Council to order. Reverend Marty Joplin, First Baptist Church. Morning, Gage.
Let's pray. Father and gracious God, you have been kind to us. You have given us a community that is safer than many. You've given us a community that is aware of its responsibility to seek your face, to call upon you in time of need. God, we want to lift before you right now those people who are confused and hurting in Boston. And we just pray that your spirit would descend on that city in a very special way. Allow the healing to begin. God, give us the wisdom we need for tonight. Give us insight, communication abilities, and God, may we just draw all things from you so that we can return all glory to you. We pray this in the name of the one who is risen, resurrected from the dead, victorious over the grave, and our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Motion and second to approve the minutes as distributed of the special session of April 8th, 2013.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any change to the agenda, Mayor?
No, Mayor. There isn't.
Motion and second to approve the order of the agenda.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Information presentation and public hearing. Hereby open the public hearing for the CDBG.
Good evening. This is a public hearing to discuss the city's submission of an application for the fiscal year 2013 Community Development Block Grant Program. The city is proposing an application to demolish several unsafe, dilapidated structures within the city limits. They are properties that have already had notice of demolition orders sent to each of the property owners. Based on the initial feedback from the property owners, the total project estimated cost is approximately $394,000. The city proposes to contribute $24,000 in cash and $10,000 in kind labor by city crews. There will be approximately $110,000 private funds, and the grant will be for $250,000. The public hearing is required as part of the application process, and the cost of the public hearing notice is the only direct cost to the public hearing tonight.
Any questions or comments? Does anyone in the audience have any questions or comments? Okay.
Mayor, I do want to mention for this particular grant itself, this is Sarah had said that these are properties that we've already identified. If we can get the funds and we can get the property owners to participate, one is the old high school, and the other is the building located next door to us.
Miller Building?
Yes. So, and then there's a few buildings across around the city. Most of them are old homes or residential structures.
A lot of the residential structures were left to people by grandparents, great aunts and uncles. A couple of them someone bought with the intention of fixing them up and moving here eventually. So the demolition notice says you either have to repair it or tear it down. And most of them are at the point that they're deciding they would like to tear the property down.
Do you know what the chances are of getting the CDBG?
We don't know. We won't know until after August at the earliest. Okay. And we do have to have a sign-in sheet passed around as well, so
okay.
As part of the public hearing requirement.
Thank you, Sarah. Anything else, Mary? Okay, close this hearing. Next, we're going to do excellence in financial reporting and award presentation. Okay.
I'm here to present the official plaque that we received from the GFOA for our fiscal year end 2011 for our financial reporting, which I'm working currently on the 2012 year end. So this is a kind of good time to remind me what I'm working for. So It's a lot of effort, but I'm here to present this today to the City Council.
Mayor, if we could get a picture of you and Katie. And this is actually the last year when Katie received the award. It was actually from
2010
when she was not here, but this is
for the 2011 year that I closed out. Yeah.
Congratulations. This was yours.
Well, yes and no. It was a year accumulation of someone else's, but I closed it out. This next year is going to be mine.
That's perfect.
All right. One, two, three. Take one more. One, two, three.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And Mayor, while you're walking back up, I will mention that the significance of receiving this certificate of achievement is really to tell the community, citizens, that the financial reporting is to the standard that is expected for governmental entities, and the report that is prepared is one that people can look at and actually, you know, get information that, you know, helpful information or information about how the city operates.
Okay, Arbor Day proclamation. I have one here for a graduate.
The Arbor Day one, I believe we've already passed it on to the department.
I saw, okay. Okay, then Graduate Education Week proclamation presentation. Whereas a graduate education attracts students from across the nation and the world to universities in Missouri, and in particular in Kirksville, and whereas graduate schools are the only place where highly skilled leaders and experts in a variety of fields are prepared to address local, national, and global challenges, and whereas graduate education contributes to the good of society, ensuring its economic, social, and cultural prosperity, and whereas the city of Kirksville and the surrounding region benefit from the presence and the contributions of Truman State University's graduate students in accounting, biology, communications disorders, education, English, and music. Now therefore, I, Richard L. Dowell, Mayor of the City of Kirksville, do hereby proclaim April 13th to April 20th, 2013, as Graduate Education Week. Signed by the Mayor of the City of Kirksville, is 15th day of April, 2013.
I'm just
going to
see if there's anybody in the audience.
Is there anybody here? Oh, come on forward.
That's great.
Right here in the front, and we'll get a picture.
Yeah, just line up here with your backs to the council. You can trust them.
You take the picture first. Okay. Squeeze in. Like we like each other. Okay. One, two, three. Take one more. One, two, three. Great. Pictures? Okay.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
One more person.
Thank you very much. What's your interest?
Communications.
Communications?
All three of us.
Disorders. Oh, okay.
I'm Janet Gooch. I'm the dean of the School of Health Sciences.
Oh, yeah. Don't say the same place.
Yeah.
Pretty good students here.
Yes, definitely.
What's your name?
David Gilroy.
David? Where are you from?
Kansas City.
Kansas City. What's your major?
English. And I work for the Dean of Graduate Studies, so I'm here for her.
Excellent. Thank you for coming here to go to school. We appreciate that.
Mayor, I think we want to get one more picture.
Oh, you're welcome.
One more picture. We want to get one more picture.
Oh.
Yeah.
I've seen it here.
Yes. She's a garden.
How are you doing?
Professor.
Communication.
Hi, everybody.
Mayor, I think we want to get one.
Yes, we want to get
it. Out of the way.
Senator Chin, let's see if we can get it all in one. We may have to do two lines. Can't quite get you guys in. Why don't you guys step forward, the three in the middle,
yeah.
Then you guys fill in kind of in the back. There we go. Okay. One, two, three.
Are you a photographer, Rachel?
She did that very well.
That's good.
No, but I'm a mom. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is yours.
No, that's for you.
Oh.
Okay, at this point, we'll do citizen participation. If anybody cares to step forward and talk for 5 minutes on any subject not listed on the agenda. Yes, sir. Please step forward.
You want me up here?
No, just the podium right there. Just state your name and your living address.
My name is Paul Molnix. I actually live in Moore, Idaho, 1,400 miles away. But I and my sisters own several properties in North Kirksville. And I am here because of a proposed propane bulk plant on Northtown Road. Now first there's an issue with the zoning of that, the determination. And right now it's, it goes behind Aldi's. You probably noticed a little bit of work back there. And that's M1. Light industrial, but there's two problems with 30,000 gallons of propane there. One is that by any stretch of the imagination, 30,000 gallons of propane is not light in anybody's book. In fact, that's about three times a threshold where all kinds of federal regulations come in for emergency evacuation, medical services, and so forth. Now, a danger zone is about 4/10 of a mile around the center of that, and that is for a 1 psi pressure wave, I guess, which would blow out the windows of a building. Now, that 4/10 of a mile covers an awful lot of residential and prime commercial property up there, including Walmart, Elliott Pharmacy, Aldi's of course, Comfort Inn, Burger King, Shockey's Court, which is part of the property that I and my sisters own. But also on that, the going east, it goes clear over into part of Worcester Hills. And it includes like six mobile home parks in the area. And it also includes Dare County District Ambulances is in that zone, which means if there's an accident or an act of terrorism that blows up the north end of town, when you need ambulances the most, the ambulances may be completely out of service. And so it's a big problem. Now the other thing about the zone determination, and that is the material itself. M1 lists under box storage many different materials. You know, there's a big long paragraph, it lists many different things. Propane is not one of those materials. Now you go to M2 and it is listed there. So on at least two counts, I think the zoning is completely off. Now there's another problem, maybe a bigger problem, maybe for the whole city, and that is the way this whole thing comes off. This whole thing, it seems like it's been behind closed doors under the table. I went around to several businesses up there today, including Walmart, places like Aldi's, Sonic, Burger King, Comfort Inn, Elliott Pharmacy. There isn't a soul up there that knows a thing about it, let alone all the residences, which goes clear into Worcester Hills, and some of them go over to Farm and Home, and I think another trailer park, it's a big area. And nobody knows anything about it. And only not until last week have I learned anything about it. And not only do the business people don't know anything about it, but the city doesn't know anything about it. And this whole thing seems to be by one person, and that's Brad Selby. And Brad told my sister this morning, as soon as those drawings comes in, it is approved. Now, how can a project like this, of this magnitude, be approved by one person, and at least one city council member I talked to didn't know anything about it? And I talked to some other city people, and nobody knows anything about it. Now, how could this ever come about? You know, like, who runs the city? Is it Brad Selby, or is it checks and balances with a real government? So I think it's a very serious issue, not only for the siting of this, but the way it came about. Now, one way is in an M1, if it is really an M1, the approval of it doesn't have to be by the city council. But this can't be an M1, not by any means. Now, not until you go into an M2 does it technically get reviewed by a city council. But this is serious enough, large enough, it impacts enough commercial and residential. I think it's got to go to the city council and be reviewed. You know, I even talked to planning and zoning. They didn't even know about it. We went through 2 years of meeting minutes of the planning and zoning, and there wasn't a single word of discussion of it. Now, one said he did know of a propane plant going in, but he didn't know of anything else. He had no idea how big it was, and it is big. So I think it's a very serious issue that someone's got to look at. And another thing interesting is that Brad Selby told my sister this morning that he sold to MFA the large propane tank they had up there. Well, if he sold that one, I don't know the details how it came about or anything, but if he sold that up there, we have a conflict of interest on what's going on here on Northtown Road. Thank you a lot.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Does anybody else care to step forward and talk about any issue else on the agenda? Okay. Action presentations. Vicki, would you please field number 23?
A resolution of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, stating intent to seek funding through the Community Development Block Grant Program and authorizing the mayor to pursue activities in an attempt to secure funding.
Motion and second.
So moved.
Second. Sarah.
This is the resolution to allow us to apply for said Community Development Block Grant. It is another housekeeping item. We have to have a resolution authorizing signatures for the application before we can actually submit the application.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to authorize the city manager to enter into an agreement with W.L. Miller in the amount of $189,452 for the expansion of the airport parking lot and hangar driveway. Motion and second.
So moved.
Second.
Mayor and Council, this is a project that is going to be funded largely by the state of Missouri through their aviation funds. And the idea of the project is to expand our parking lot at the airport. And then also behind the FBO building, it's going to be, the parking area is going to be improved. And if you remember, there is a dock off the backside of the FBO building that will be improved as well. So it's just a major capital improvement project. W.L. Miller was the only bidder on the project, and JAviation has gone through their bids and is recommending the approval of W.L. Miller.
So now with the increased traffic, you're seeing a lot of vehicles parking on the grass and getting stuck on the snow. Mm-hmm. Okay, any other questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve a request for the use of public facility airport for a special event sponsored by the Chamber of After Hours program on April 18th, 2013, allowing for the consumption of alcohol on airport property. Motion and second.
So moved.
Second.
Jim.
Good evening. What you have before you tonight is a recommended motion to allow the Kirksville Chamber of Commerce with their program, the At Business After Hours, to use a public facility, that being the airport. Now, it's not just that use that they're requesting tonight. A number of years ago, City Council made a determination and set forth some criteria that would allow the use of these public facilities and specifically to allow the use of alcohol in these public facilities. So in essence, that's what we're here tonight, is getting the approval from City Council to allow the Kirksville Chamber of Commerce to have their Business After Hours program and then to serve alcohol. I might mention also on the application, the City of Kirksville is listed as a co-sponsor for this event. This is the third or fourth year that this exact same event has occurred out there. We have not had any problems in the previous three or four events. I can't remember how many it is. The alcohol vendor that is used, it will be Craig Shorten at the Dukem, and he's the same one that they've used every single time that they've had this. So. We haven't had any bad experiences with this event. So And I might mention, I mean, this is all spelled out, and there's a typo. This is City Council Policy Number 28. It's actually 21. I know you all have them committed to memory, but it is actually number 21. I don't even know if we go as high as 28, but anyway. But it's all spelled in that, and that's what we're doing tonight, is just making sure that we adhere to the City Council policy. Okay.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to appoint Sheila Pruitt to the Kirksville Tourism Advisory Board. Motion and second.
So moved.
Second.
Mayor and Council, you discussed this last week at your April Monday, about reappointing Sheila Pruitt. Sheila has already served on the tourism board for you and is willing to serve another term.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to appoint Melanie Smith to a 3-year term on the Highway 63 Transportation Corporation. Motion and second.
So moved.
Second.
Mayor and Council, at the end of last week, we realized that the city had one term. Norman Ballitz, who is at the Bank of Kirksville, he has already served two 3-year terms on the corporation. We were hoping that, because we're going to be making the final payment to MoDOT, that the corporation would be able to dissolve. We haven't gotten a ruling on that yet, so we still have one. The city has one appointee to appoint at this time. So Melanie has agreed to serve. Probably is not going to be for the 3 years, or we hope it's not going to be for the 3 years, because we don't have any business to take care of.
Okay. Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
City clerk reading of bills that were adopted on first reading.
We do not have any tonight.
There's no recommendation. Okay. Council comments. Anybody have any council comments they want to make? No?
Mayor, I would like to invite you all, since you approved the business after hours out of the airport on Thursday, to if you can make it out there, 5 to 7 p.m.
Okay. I guess I would comment that I'm happy to be a part of the council this time.
I'd like to welcome Glenn here. He's our newest member. Okay, motion and second to adjourn to executive session.
So moved.
Concerning personnel matter.
Second.
Okay. Vicki?
Okay, personnel and real estate.
Oh, personnel and real estate matter. Okay.
Mayor Detweiler?
Aye.
And Councilmember Mills?
Aye.
Councilmember Russell?
Aye.
Councilmember Moritz?
Aye.
And Councilmember Edge?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for coming. I appreciate it.
You've just been watching the April 15th, 2013 Kirksville City Council meeting.